What is the difference for the roots of the plants between growing in a pot and growing in aquaponics? This is what we're going to see together in this video. We will also see why most gardeners haven't started aquaponics yet. So you see, when I repot a plant, like the one I have behind me, this one, I always put some scoria on the first centimeters on the bottom of the pot. And there is a very specific reason for that. So scoria, for the ones who are not used to my videos with aquaponics, this is a volcanic rock that is very porous. So it allows the water inside the pot to drain and to not remain stagnant on the bottom of the pot. And that's something I do for all my indoor plants. I really like to do this, and I found some really good results. Because all gardeners know, if you have some indoor plants, you know that the plants, they need to drink, so you have to water them. Generally, we water the indoor plants once a week, depending on the spaces, depending on the temperature you have inside, depending on a lot of parameters. But what we want is to basically have the inside of the pot to be moist, and we also want to make sure we offer enough moisture for the plants, but we want also avoid to have too much stagnant water inside the pot. And that's something all gardeners are afraid of, because stagnant water is gonna basically increase the anaerobic area in the pot. So if you have some water that is staying on the bottom of the pot, then you have area without oxygen and the root of the plants are gonna rot. So that's one thing. And that's also the reason why so many gardeners don't understand why in aquaponics it works, because they think, well, my plants indoor, if I put a bit of water, if I put a bit too much water, and if the water remain inside the pot, the plant is gonna start to rot. While in aquaponics, they understand that there is very often water, you know, there is incoming water 24/7 in the grow bed. So they imagine that the roots of the plants are always in contact with moisture, and therefore that the plants are going to be in anaerobic conditions, which means without oxygen. So the roots are going to rot. While the gardeners need to understand the difference between moist environment and anaerobic. In aquaponics, as you may know, we have a bell siphon and we allow the level of water in the grow bed to go up and down several times per hour. So I'm going to show you what the bell siphon looks like. You see, that's it. Here we got a bell siphon, it's a bell. And basically when the water level reach a certain point in the grow bed, it flushes everything at once into the fish tank. So we got fish tanks here. And when basically the grow bed reaches a certain level, it flushes everything into the fish tank. So this is empty of water then, which means that all the roots of the plants are able to breathe several times per hour. We have this phenomenon, and so we don't have anaerobic environment. And that's really the anaerobic environment that is bad for the plants, for the roots of the plant, not the moisture by itself. Now, that's right, that the plants have a zone. So if you like, if you look at a plant, there is a part between the roots that are deep inside the media and the leaves. Between at the surface here, this this connection, we call it the neck. The neck of the plant must not be into the water. Some plants really don't like to have the neck in a moist environment. So it depends on the species. Some species of plant, like aquatic plants, obviously they live completely in the water. You got some plants that don't really mind to have the neck in a moist environment. But most of the plants we grow in a garden, they don't really like to keep the neck in a moist environment. It's going to be an opportunity for disease. It's going to weaken the plant. So it's very important when you have an aquaponic system to keep the surface of the media dry. See, the surface is completely dry here. This media that I have on the surface, the scoria here, is dry, and that's really super important. If you have it wet, well, your plants may not grow. You're going to have plants that are never going to grow in your setup. And if you find that some plants are not able to grow in the aquaponic system that you have, it may be because of this specific thing, right? You have the media that is maybe not wet on the surface, maybe the surface is dry, but just underneath it's wet. And some plants need to have maybe 4 centimeters dry. So it really depends. You can make some trials and you can modify the height of basically the bell siphon, you know, into your grow bed. You may want the level of water, maximum level of water, to be still 5 centimeters below the maximum level of your media. So you leave the top dry, and the plants are going to grow better. So depending on the species of plants you are growing, you may want the water there, you may want the water there. Generally, we say 3 to 5 centimeters is good, but some plants, if you want to put cactus, you will have to go way lower, right? Obviously, I don't think anyone want to grow cactus in aquaponics, probably not the best idea, but you get the idea. Some plants that don't like moisture, you have to go a bit deeper. So if you are a gardener and you haven't started aquaponics, now you can understand why aquaponics is working, even if there is always moisture on the deep part of the grow bed. Is because obviously all the surface is still dry, so you get a lot of aeration. Even the deep roots, they have access to oxygen because the water level is going down. So that's why in aquaponics we can grow some food without problem. So if you're a gardener, I really recommend you to try aquaponics, try at small scale, and you will see the results. You will probably be quite impressed. If you really want to go ahead with this, we have a free training in the description of the video, or in the I like information on the corner of the video somewhere. And if you go through this link, you're going to have access to a training, a free training to help you to build your own aquaponic system in the best conditions. I'm going to give you all the limits, the critical limit to respect when you build your aquaponic system, and some really good tips to manage your aquaponic system in the best conditions. So it's a quick training, 6 steps, very easy to go through. It's free, it's in the description, so get it now. So once you get access to the free training, you will arrive to this page. And here you will have a detail of different steps. And each time you got a video or some description to really allow you to build some strong knowledge and to know and to learn the basics of aquaponics, so to avoid any mistakes. So just enter your email address and you will receive access to this training. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I see you in the next video. Bye!